Hello guys, and welcome to Battlefront. I'm of course the main commentator, John Alderman, alongside Jason Todd.
It is great to be here for another edition of Battlefront, and a huge edition of Battlefront is coming your way.
Yeah, huge edition of Battlefront is coming your way as well. This wasn't on my... Coming out now, Dom, King of Swerve.
Yeah, your notes doesn't say anything about him, does it?
No,
mine don't either.
Alright, well, guys, coming down now is Dom, and let's see what he has to say.
Yeah, let's listen to Tom the King is swerving. And I wasn't expecting this at all.
I was expecting Jason right now.
Yeah, Jason to go one-on-one action.
Well, I mean, he's got a bat. Let's see what he has to say.
Well, I hear he has, history in the world of baseball.
Yeah, that's very true. Very well known in baseball. Now let's see what he's going to do here.
Yeah, we'll find out what he's going to do, but yeah. Give him the mic right now.
Well, saying, well, hello, ladies and gentlemen. You may be wondering why I'm starting Battlefront this week. That is because Swerve, I am the new GM of Battlefront. That's right, the King of Swerve is here to take over. And tonight we will be having a EU, or European, and Battlefront side of the tag, no more contention match. I won't get bad, but don't make me disappointed in you.
Oh, well, it's always like that said. I'm not mad, I'm just disappointed.
Yeah, well. Let's see how it... We got ourselves a new GM.
Yeah, we have a new GM. We have unexpectedly... Didn't expect that at all, but well... We must move on to the first match of the night.
Yeah, we're moving on to our first match of the night. We have Jason going to get the debuting Brody Robertson here.
Let's see how the debuting Brody Robertson fares in this one-on-one contest. Against Jason, who will only be in on his second contest here tonight.
He'll be only in his second, and then, of course, coming out first, coming over from the MMA field, it is Brody Robertson.
Quite the man in the world of MMA, but is now a part of Randy Barris that has a contract here, and well, we'll see how he fares in his debut match of transitioning over from the world of MMA to the world of wrestling. It's definitely going to be, an interesting look into this man, what he can do against Jason.
Yeah, let's see what he can do against Jason. Of course, Brody Robertson coming from Glasgow, Scotland. And of course, he has a manager with him, a manager that has brought him to the top of the world in MMA. Now he's here with him to bring him to the top of the world. Here in professional wrestling, of course, in Shane Sullivan. And let's see if this power duo can get a big win here tonight against Jason.
Let's see if they'll be able to do it. Be able to, use that MMA experience to try to brutalize Jason here tonight. Get a big victory in a debut matchup.
Big debut matchup for Brody Robertson. Let's see what he can do here. Well, coming out next, it is Jason.
So, Jason had his debut match, and he did a farewell in that debut. We'll see how he can try and bounce back here tonight. See if he can pick up big victory against an MMA star in only his second contest to really ruin the debut of Brody.
We saw what he was able to do against Ray Lethal. He started off very strong, but then towards the end of the match, Ray Lethal really took over and got a big win over Jason. Let's see if Jason can learn from his mistakes last week. Well, I think it was actually 2 weeks ago, and get a big win here tonight against, a big MMA star.
We'll see if we have to do that. I mean, it's not be easy against an MMA star guy who's dominated the world of MMA. The success of them now looks to become a success here in the world of professional wrestling. So Jason is gonna have a tough time.
He's gonna have a very tough time here. Because, I mean, if there's anyone that knows a little bit about conditioning, it's going to be a man like Brody Robertson going over from the MMA scene. He knows how to get it done inside the octagon. Let's see if he can do it here in the squared circle. Jason, who do you have in this one?
No, for sure. I'm going to go with the MMA killer. I'm going to cover Brody Robertson for this one here. An experience he has in the octagon in simply just fighting people. So it could really give him an advantage. But this is not something you see in MMA.
No, it's not. Look at that, Brody taking over Jason already, and then Shane Sullivan on the outside, certainly excited for him here in his debut, is now taking him to the center. What is Brody looking to do? But no, Jason able to get right back up, but able to get the punch out of the way. Now, no, wasn't able to capitalize, but now he's going for a big German suplex.
Difference is this could be stuff. Now that happens to Brody Robertson that he isn't used to. You know, stuff that happens in the world of professional wrestling, you don't see the world of, you know, mixed martial arts. Stuff that Brody Robertson isn't used to.
Yeah, it's definitely not going to be used to. Like things like covers here, but submissions could be definitely a big specialty here for Brody Robertson. Or, of course, you know, we have Boy Demise with the Knockout Championship.
That could be quite a matchup. And Brody Robertson
gets back to us.
Big capture suplex.
Yeah, huge suplex there by Brody. And now, but oh, look at this. Jason winning a power struggle.
I don't know if you could see that, but now Jason, what is he going for? Oh, goodness. He drops his head on the knee.
One, two, no.
And so Brody Robertson got to contend with the fact that he's gonna end up taking moves that in a world of MMA would be considered quite illegal.
Yeah, it would be quite illegal, but very legal here in professional wrestling. And it looks like he's already adapting very well over onto the professional scene here. But now, what is Jason looking to do? Throwing Brody to the outside.
Oh no.
Now, what is he thinking here? But right in front of Shane Sullivan here.
Jason doing, oh no, no,
has
no.
Him up, oh my god!
Just driving him with the powerbomb into the ring apron. But look at this, Brody Robertson trying to fight back.
Yeah, he's trying to fight back, but wasn't able to. Now, Brody, what is he looking to do? Taking down Jason.
Taking down that sleep slam.
Set up for something big here.
Oh!
A big kick there. And now, continuing on him.
Continuing a kick in that arm. And now could be very well injured. Just such a brutal move. It's a big bulldog.
Yeah, big bulldog here is... Oh, wait a minute.
Huh?
I don't think this is legal in MMA.
No, definitely not. I don't even know if this is legal in professional wrestling.
When do we start signing superheroes?
Has science gone too far?
Yeah, well, I didn't know we signed a Silver Surfer, but,
Or, Colossus.
Oh, looks like his power is...
He's powered down. He ran out of key energy. He cannot become Colossus.
No.
Next thing you know, we're gonna have bloody super signs around here. Oh, good lord, all the way coming down.
All the way coming down as well. I think Brody could very well be tired out from whatever he just did there.
He became a metal man. Something.
Some sort of metal man. Like I said, definitely not legal in MMA. I barely even know if, you know, Dom's even gonna find that legal here.
Yeah, right now he's not mad, he might be disappointed though.
He might be disappointed that he's using superpowers. And still hasn't won yet.
That too. He's tried for a kick and chased him in his counter, but no. Brody Robertson taking him into the corner.
Bringing him to the corner now. Big headbutt there, now continuing his. Oh, now what is Brody looking to do?
Oh boy, we've seen this movement knock how many people? Oh goodness!
Drive by drop kick. Could that be it for Jason? But Brody's taking in his handiwork here. Is that going to be too much time wasted?
think it is too much time wasted. And then maybe he's realised. He's not going for a cut. Maybe he realised it was too much time wasted. Same time, I think he should have gone for a cut. I mean, I'm forced Chase on to use up energy. Oh, goodness. Diamond with the elbow drop.
And now Brody looking to continue on Chase on here. Now is he looking to do lifting him up? Take down there. Oh, what a huge knee straight there. Jason's reeling now.
Yeah, he is reeling now. It's a brutal knee strike. And now look at this. Just shoved a foot across the face. And now. Oh, goodness.
Just a big boot there. And but he's not done. Still not going for the cover. Just what is Brody thinking of here?
I don't know if he's trying to send a message, just toying around with Jason, but that could come back to haunt him.
Yeah, it could very well. Is now Jason starting to fight back here, starting to get back into it here. Has him up, but no, Brody able to get his way out of it there. But now Jason fighting back, and now what's it? This taken down cover. One,
spit.
Two, no.
Oh, Brody Robertson able to kick out before the three.
It's now, is Jason trying to knock out Brody here?
He's suddenly trying to do that. May have succeeded in it. Can you imagine? And roll him over, rolling that dead weight over there. Cover.
Two.
Maybe if he hooked the leg, could just got that one bit closer to three. We maybe could have got a three, but that not hooking leg could be a mistake.
Yeah, it could be, but now what is he going for?
Oh no, he's been caught! Big catcher suplex.
Yeah, big suplex there now. What is he looking to? But no, Jason fighting back here, throwing down Brody. Now Brody trying to fight back on his own here, going for a chokehold here. Rope break immediately. Good look there by Jason.
Yeah, very good. I mean, a mistake from Brody Robertson at the same time. It's far too close for him to lock in that sleeper hold. But it was also great on Jason's part to grab towards the ropes.
Now what is Jason looking to do? Throwing down Brody, going for the cover. One, two, no!
Still not enough and to get Jason, make him sit there and not hook in the leg. It's so important to hook that leg. Look at that. It's these two struggling with exhaustion, it seems.
Yeah, these two have been going at it for very long here, so long.
Is that
right? Turn the lights off on them.
What? They're like, take it home, boys.
Yeah, I think that's the definite home. Take it home. But now, what is Jason looking to do? Throwing him down. Big kick to the back.
Big kick. Do you think that could be it? Is that coming? But once again, he's not hooking the leg.
Two. And then once again, Brody able to kick out.
Jason really needs to get in the hang of, you know, hooking that leg. It's one of the most important things when it comes to going for a cover.
But he's really been able to hold his own this week against Brody Robertson. But oh, look at this!
Major Samoan drop. You can see Jason is exhausted. And both these two are.
Jason really staggering now. He has to do something big here. Pop up, powerbomb!
Oh my goodness, I just bring him down, that brutal powerbomb. And that could be a Chase Song grab for the cover, but again.
Look at the leg. But it didn't mean it.
It doesn't matter, Chase Song just picked up a monumental victory.
Yeah, very monumental victory for Chase Song. Well, Brody Robertson was able to get his winning debut, but definitely a great outing between these two here. Jason picking up a big victory.
You can see it looks like he got cut during the match. It's a little bit of blood trickling from the Pantana, but at the end day, Jason is your victor here tonight.
Jason, the victor here tonight. We're going to be moving on as the Rouge Bates is going to go on against, well, another big debut here in Chiquito.
The T is silent.
I want to say that's how you say it.
I'm pretty sure, you know, I'd be pretty positive that's how you say it. Sukiku. So, we'll probably get corrected about it if you're wrong.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, we're going to be moving on to, well, coming out first, she is part of the clergy, Louise Bates.
Well, Louise Bates here, part of the clergy, you know what feels on them. But Louise Bates, well, that's weird. When did the clergy get inflatable tube buddies?
What are you talking about? They always have buddies.
Whatever. Well, Louise Bates will be looking to, you know, ruin the debut of Sukiku tonight. Just so we see what another debut ruined here tonight. See if Louise Bates can be successful.
Could not be the night to debut here if Louise Bates can get a big victory here tonight over Sukiku.
That mask has only made me think of one thing.
A virus of sorts?
Da 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 da. My Corona.
Your Corona.
Great drink.
Yeah. Very good drink. Only with the lime.
But of course, you gotta have the lime.
Well, coming out next, making her debut, Sukiku.
This is Sukiko.
You're saying too, and I was like, okay.
Yeah, it's because of the two part of France, but we'll Sukiko. See. If Sukiko can get a major victory tonight in her debut, she could do ring a world class athlete. I'm sure she would have done her homework, you know, against Louise Bates. I'm sure Louise Bates sort of watched, you know, Sukiko's matches, you know, do her own kind of scouting.
I'm sure she has been doing her scouting on her to try and get a good feel on how she's going to be going on here tonight. Let's see if Louise Bates can get a big win here tonight, or is it going to be a big debut here for Sukiko?
If we pronounce it wrong, we'll get corrected.
Oh, we will.
A plot twist, it might be, you never know, it might be, so she might go and say, actually, no, you were right when you said Sukiku.
That could be a plot twist. But for now, it's Sukiko. So, Jason, who you got? Jason, he was just wrestling. Jason, who you got going in this one?
Well, you know my feelings on the clergy, so I have to go to debut in.
So you're going to go for Louise Bates?
No, Sukiko, I think. Now, she could have a successful debut. It's, as I said, a world-class athlete. She's traveled the world. She's had, you know, monumental performances. Same goes, you know, for Louise Bates, but I think Sukiko with her style can, you know, outmaneuver and outpace Louise Bates.
She could very well indeed, but we're going to have to see here. So, Sukiko going up there. And, that big kick! And you see the way that she made Louise Bates real there. That is not good. That was a huge kick there by Sukiko, and now holding her down.
Oh, and planting that knee into her back of the head, and Louise Bates is in some trouble. Goodness. Super kick. That's a jaw. Sukiko is all kinds of fired up.
All kinds of fired up here is now throwing her against the ropes there. Oh my god, meeting her as she hits the ropes.
You know, and the head ropes that cartwheel kick, but you see Louise Bates trying to fight back, and it's a huge clothesline.
Corner! But look at that. Cover! No! I thought Sukiko almost stole one there against Louise Bates, but no, she was able to kick out there, and now Sukiko continuing on against Louise, but no big fireman's carry.
Looked like Louise Bates was going to catch her there, but Sukiko had, you know, a counter to her. Yet again with a counter.
Yeah, never big counter there, but able to grab the leg and then a good kick there to the back of the head. Now Louise, she's definitely feeling it here.
And now she's the one who's feeling fired up. Oh boy, Asuki come up top. What is she gonna go for?
Superplex.
Oh my god!
Oh, wait, she's not done. Using the momentum. Continues.
Oh!
Cover.
It's a Falcon Arrow.
Two. No. And somehow, someway, Takiko able to kick out there. But now Louise continues to a big Russian leg sweep.
Huge, huge Russian leg sweep. But look, this Takiko again.
Two. No. She almost stole one there, but now she's looking to continue a big kick here. Knockout blow. Could that be enough?
It could be. Is that once again covering?
Two. People are not able to get a big win there, but let's see if she can continue on with Louise Bates here.
Oh, my God. Yeah, caught her into a code break, and that could be it.
Two.
No. Oh, Louise Bates able to kick after being launched into the air and fell into a code breaker.
Yeah, but I don't think Sakika's really worrying about it here. She's looking to try and maybe continue here against Louise, but no. Great job up to there, but no, wait. Now she's going here, throwing her down into the ropes. Louise trying to get a breather here.
I didn't know if she tried to get a breather, but maybe she should have rolled out fully to the ring. Sakiko, what is she waiting for? Could be making a huge mistake.
Louise Bates to get a good breather. Was able to catch her there, but now Sakiko taking back control with those big lethal kicks.
And oh goodness, yes, some monumental kicks. She's got, you know, that kicking range power to Sakiko. It's made her so dangerous. She's got those educated feet and a quick count again.
Big hit to the legs here, and now has her up.
Oh, reverse DDT. You can see, I think Louise Bates trying to see if Sakiko has, you know, some form of counter to.
Some sort of counter is now taking her down. Wrenching back on the arms there. Oh, but Louise able to fight her way out and taken down.
Taken down the hard way. And now Louise Bates a handful of hair throws a kick around the ring.
Yeah, throws her around the ring here. Big kick. Not able to get it. Oh, missed there. Now Louise Bates able to go into a big Russian right sweep.
It brings her down, it beats up Russian leg sweep, but now Sakiko's just trying to get a breather here.
Yeah, but Louise Bates not winding up here. As big suplex there, back inside the ring.
Bringing it back in the hard way. But Sakiko just again wants to try to fight back, but no, Louise Bates once again gets her.
Look at this!
Oh my god!
Cover!
Into a cutter!
Two!
No! Sakiko is able to kick out after that brutal cutter from Louise Bates.
Yeah, big cutter there was not enough for Louise Bates, but now Sakiko, what is she looking to do? Fighting back here, but now into the corner. Oh, big strike here. Now what is Louise Bates looking to do here?
She planned it. Something devastating by the looks of it.
The double knees!
Yeah, those double knees into the sternum. That could be a Sakiko. Could be out of it.
Two, three, and she is. The win fully out of Sakiko there. Louise Bates able to pick up the victory.
Gives Sakiko credit for her big debut and the kind of force, you know, kind of fight she brought to the ring. How much she gave it all in this match. Benny and Louise Bates just a better woman.
And Louise Bates, the better woman tonight here. Big win for Louise Bates for the clergy. Of course, they have a big match later on tonight, but for now, big win for Lethal. We're going to be moving on as Ray Lethal will be going 1-on-1 against Marcus Williams.
What a match. This is going to be more great action coming your way. You'll see a very dangerous Ray Lethal take on a technical gift to Marcus Williams, which should be, you know, one hell of a contest.
It should be one hell of a contest, guaranteed. As coming out first is Ray Lethal.
Ray Lethal, as I said, he is a dangerous individual. He's a coach who seems to, you know, just enjoy taking pain and then dishing it out 10 times worse. We've seen it when he took on Jason. He took some punishment in the beginning match, and then he just dished it out in such a worse way to pick up the victory.
Well, he was able to get a big win in his debut, season debut against Jason. It was a very huge victory. Now he's going to be looking to try and continue that here. As I'm getting some notes about this match, we're going to talk about that when the match starts. But for now, Ray Lethal definitely looking to try and get a big win here tonight.
Yes, I'd be looking to do that, to score a major victory, to, you know, climb up those rankings towards, you know, title contention. His opponent, Marcus Williams, will be trying to do the same. He will try to stop Ray Lethal and pick up the victory for himself.
Looking ready here. Let's see if he can continue his success that he has been having recently, or is the anti-hero going to be able to stop him here tonight?
Yeah, we'll see if the anti-hero can be the one who stops Ray Lethal. And yeah, well, has been some successful and impressive victories. Whether Ray Lethal's, you know, streak continues.
Coming out next, he is the anti-hero, Marcus Williams.
We'll see if the anti-hero could stop Rayleigh for streak. You know, stop his impressive run of victories. Maybe Marcus Williams could start on, you know, a streak of his own. See how the anti-hero fares in this and try and, you know, set all that climb those rankings and get those title opportunities.
Marcus Williams, he's certainly a man that can do that here. He hasn't had one of the best of records, but he has been putting on amazing matches here, and he'll be looking to try and continue that here tonight as he goes against Ray Lethal, which should be a very huge match for him here tonight.
And that will be a huge, huge matchup. And these two of the very best we have in this company, and they're going to prove it here tonight. And put on, you know, a monumental performance to see who is the better man and, yeah, who walks away with the victory.
Guys did actually go against each other last week. I do believe Ray Lethal did get the win last week. Let's see if he'll be able to do it again.
Forgot about that. No, we'll see. Yeah. I don't know why I forgot about it, but there was also part of me in my mind thinking, I swear to this guy's face, but I didn't feel like bringing it up. Well, maybe I was just thinking things. But yeah, who knows? We'll see. Maybe Mark Swims can get a victory, and then maybe we can see, you know, a third match between them, the rubber match. Or maybe Ray Leaf will just go, screw that idea, I get both wins.
Yeah, some might say, maybe Dom.
Maybe he really loved that match and wanted to see it again.
That would be a swerve, wouldn't it?
That would be a swerve.
Speaking of swerves, this match is actually, he did talk about it before, it's going to be a European Number Contention match. And that's this match right here. Ray Lethal, Marcus Williams, who's going to be going against Jacob Wells at Nowhere to Run next Saturday night.
Gotta think, I imagine if Marcus Williams gets the victory today, as into a cover though, looking at the leg, Marcus Williams gets the victory because I'm a contender. Ray Lethal may be, he may be mad about it. And say, well, look, I beat that guy last week. Where's the number one contendership there? But hey, Dobbs, you know, a man who likes to swerve the people.
He is a giant swerve, indeed. And he'll be looking to try and do some swerves throughout the season here. And well, all you gotta say is, he'll never be mad. But you do not want to get him disappointed.
Oh, certainly not.
Marcus Williams looking to try and get it here. And I'm being told here, another big story about this match. These guys don't even know that this match is the European number of times.
My goodness. So one of them, when they get backstage, is going to be very happy. The other one's going to go, hey, what the fuck? Are you making this up as you go along?
Dom might be.
Maybe.
That's all about the swerves.
Oh, I get it. It's a nasty dragon sleeper.
Yeah, could this be enough? But no, Mark is able to fight his way out of it.
Yeah, it is Dom unscripted swerves.
He might very well be.
I've heard of unscripted violence, now we have unscripted swerves.
Well, he is the king of swerves.
That really is a paradigm shift.
Yeah, but Mark Sweeney trying to go for a cutter here. Ray Lethal, just like everyone else in the offseason, reword how to stop those cutters.
But now, Timber couldn't stop that.
No, couldn't stop. Well, I mean, Ray Lethal wasn't the one man to have a word to worry about stopping it.
But I see him up. Pump had a Death Valley drum, and that could be a cover. Look at the leg.
Two. No. Ray Lethal thinking, what does he need to do to get a, well, for him in his mind, just to get the victory here tonight, not even the European No More Contendership.
Yeah, he doesn't know, but look at this. Beautiful agility shown by Marcus Williams.
Do you think he's going to take a while with him?
I hope not. That'd be hilarious.
I don't think he does.
Ah!
Oh. What a big cobra in there. Cover. Marcus Williams. One. Two. No.
Oh. Ray Lethal. Kick out. It's the thing about Ray Lethal is his longevity ring. You just keep punishing him. He just keeps coming back. Look at this.
Has him up.
Oh my goodness. Double under a twisted neck breaker.
Two. No.
No.
Ray Lethal.
Ray Lethal.
Barely able to stay alive.
Yeah, he was just able to kick out. But I said that's the longevity of Ray Lethal. It's the fact that if you could just keep punching, he just seems to keep coming back and wanting more.
And now Marcus Williams, he looks like he's waiting for something here. Don't know what he was waiting for, but Ray Lethal was able to get a breather, take back control here. You know, ref, I think that was a cover, but he didn't care. But able to get out of it there was Marcus Williams. He's now going up.
Oh!
Down he goes.
Oh, look at this. Ray Lethal's immediately back up.
Yeah, immediately back up and now stretching those arms back as far as he can.
Oh. Trying to stretch those arms out of their sockets. Ray Lethal just trying to bring the pain.
But now Mark's going to be able to fight his way out of it here. As again, trying to go for that cutter. Ray Lethal had him. Wait, look at this. Reverse DDT, cover. One. No, only a one count.
And just a one count. He was hooking a leg there. So it's just showing you that Ray Lethal still has that fight in him. He still has the ability to keep going and going.
Marcus Williams right back up and started swinging.
He started swinging for the fences after he decided to no-sell a powerbomb.
Oh, he kicked right back up. I think that was just pure adrenaline going. I think he might have even not been knocked down. He was just in fight mode.
Yeah, I think so. Look at this.
Powerbomb of his own. They're off the ropes for assistance. Oh, now he's going to try and put this one away.
Yeah, he's lining him up for a huge super kick.
Now, is it going to be enough cover?
See, knocked out by Henry's one.
No!
Once again, Riley will kick it out, and he's immediately back up. Uh-oh. But no! Swoops by Bam, but no, gets caught.
Big
kick! Right to the back of the head, and that could have dazed and confused Marcus Williams.
Super kick.
Oh. Right into the jaw. That could be a good night.
One, two, no! What?
Well, the mistake there, and many people seem to make it, the mistake you made there was no hook leg. If he had hooked the leg, in my opinion, it was over. He gave Marcus Williams a chance to kick out.
Yeah, but Jason didn't need it.
He didn't need it, but how many times? How much punishment did he have to dish out, and how many times did he go for that cover before it actually worked? Drives him down. That was the move. He defeated Marcus Williams with last week. He's not putting him away just yet this week.
Small version of Flatliner
and explosive at the same time.
Has him up, but no, the knee, taking him out into a huge drop kick. Oh, now what's Marcus Williams working to do?
What is he applying? Go for a cover.
Using the ropes.
Using the ropes for leverage.
No.
Beautiful and deadly combination from Ray Lethal. Marcus Williams against the ropes is looking in trouble.
Oh, look at this!
Oh!
Into the cutter!
A beautiful cutter off the handspring, and that could be enough.
One, two, no! Again! Marcus Williams able to kick out. What does Ray Lethal have to do to put away Marcus Williams there? Went for a super kick of his own. Wasn't able to get it. Now,
I tell you what he needs to do is poke that goddamn leg. When you cover, I know it worked, you know, worked for Jason not doing it, but crying out loud.
Now, has a kick. All I'm getting from today is if you had a wrestling school, you would
book the
leg.
Oh my god, book the
one,
leg.
Two, three, again. Doesn't matter.
Jesus Christ, learn. Go.
Doesn't matter. Ray
wrestling
Mitchell,
101.
Ray Mitchell, without his knowledge, just won No More Contendership for the European Championship.
He's going to be very happy when he gets backstage. I mean, yeah, he has now two victories against his opponent, and well, let's say he is now number one contender.
And
well, an interesting match as we see the spot and how he fares against our Wasteland Warrior. So we've almost got, you know, two eras against each other. You know, we've got the a post-apocalyptic future versus, you know, well, the sort of mythological sort of Greek era, the Spartan.
I mean, if we know anything about Drew Anderson, and of course Boyd DeMond as well, we can add to that. During the offseason, I mean, we signed Drew Anderson during the offseason, but they weren't some magical powers. Hasn't really been able to fully help them yet, but could have helped tonight.
Yeah, it could help tonight, we'll find out, but...
They don't play either.
Nah, he has different magical powers. It seems a few people have various different magical powers. Don't know how they got them. Doesn't seem quite all legal, but well.
Hey, I mean, is it illegal to be a suit? I don't know.
Is it illegal to be what now?
A suit. Superman. Superhuman.
Oh, okay. Mutant. Ah, damn it. We're going to get sued by Fox now. Or Disney, I should say. Should be using that term.
That's a human. Use it.
A metahuman.
Well, speaking of, coming out next is the Spartan Chase Owens.
Moving on swiftly to, the next competitor, the Spartan Chase Owens. We'll see how he fares against one half of the Wayside Warriors in this big singles contest. So Chase Owens, in matches has been impressive, has been putting on, great performances. We'll see if he's able to put on a great performance here tonight and get a win.
Yeah, I mean, he did, dip his foot in a little bit with tag team action, trying to team with Jay Mercer, but let's be real, a teaming with Jay Mercer was a failure to begin with, before he even started. Unsuccessful, then he went against Jay Mercer last week. Jay was able to pick up the victory, and now he's all over backstage saying that it was Chase Owens' fault for the loss, even though Chase didn't pick up the pinfall.
Chase got pinned at him. It's Jay
Drew!
Get down! Jay did that last week. Wait a minute. It's not them. Chase Owens has some sort of power when he gets near people. And they're near our announce table. And another goddamn metahuman to add to the list. Though Chase Owens' power is weird. All he can do is make people levitate when he's near them and then near our announce table. It's not very useful power.
Well, if he wants a breather, he just goes, go away from me.
Yeah, he just gets close and hopes and back away towards the announcer table, and then they just start levitating.
Oh,
it
sounds like how genuine it's like.
Yeah.
He was even better saying he could fly. Oh. Again, more false news from Jay Mercer.
Jay Mercer, the king of false news. Is he this company's Donald Trump?
I was gonna laugh if we just had 1, 2, 3. That was it. Bing, bing, boom. Let's get out of here.
I mean, one thing I'm thinking about is, look at this. Chase Owens may want to have some, eyes in the back of his head.
Oh, you don't think Boyd DeMond would do anything bad, or? I guess Jay would. That's true.
True, and then someone else you should have eyes in the back of their head. Drew Anderson.
He definitely should have eyes in the back of his head.
You know, there might be a certain Don Vachon, pissed off and wanting to, get blood.
Wouldn't be the first time that Don Vachon
came out. No, it certainly wouldn't. I mean, the first time he was on Battlefront, he was a Bully DeMise he attacked.
He attacked Bully DeMise to end Battlefront, and then, bang knees right there, though, by Chase Owens. But just to end that apex, we just saw Drew Anderson attack Vachon.
Yeah, we did. I mean, it was after Vachon picked up a victory against Bully DeMise. And then we looked to continue attack, and Drew Anderson obviously coming in for the save.
Drew Anderson definitely came in for the save.
Oh, God.
Big drive there. But now...
A nasty burning hammer, and that could be it.
This could be two. No. Well,
you know, I give up with telling people about hooking a leg. They're just not going to do it, even though the amount of times I keep saying, you hook that leg, you got a high chance of winning, but oh my god!
Look at this! Great power by Chase Owen, taking down Drew Anderson.
An amazing strength. Thank you! Someone
hook
who gets
the leg, but not going to get it.
Not gonna get it. That just shows you the fight that is still in Drew Anderson. But even when you hook the leg and they kick out, they're having to exert more energy than if you hadn't hooked the leg. It's a big stomp.
Leg cover. One, two, no. As I'm getting some news actually through my headset here.
Okay.
Dom and Coach Morgan have actually just agreed to a match at Nowhere to Run. We are going to see Adon Vaishon going against Bully Demise for the Knockout Championship at Nowhere to Run.
Oh my god, what a match that is going to be. Look at this, don't look in the
look
ring.
Look at this!
Oh my god! Diving through the ropes into a brutal tornado DDT.
Big kick. Now he's looking no further. No, not able to get him. Oh, flatliner there.
Flatliner on the outside. It's always said about how much worse moves are on the outside. No,
protected under the magic. There's the magic. Oh, God.
Chase Owens is like, oh, I'm out of this. Oh, goodness. Are you okay?
I think I am.
Oh, he caught the hand!
Wait, is Spartan catch magic?
We really are in Greek mythological times. Okay, I'm putting it in now. It is banned from hiring anyone called Medusa. We are never hiring anyone called Medusa.
Why? She has great hair.
Yeah, they'll kill you.
He's gotta put, you know, some shades on. You know, get the
hair straight. I don't know. I'd rather not risk it.
Hey, I mean, that would be a great addition to the women's roster.
Also, no hiring anyone called Kratos. You're just going around backstage going, boy.
And now, look at this, she's throwing Drew back inside the ring.
And back inside, and back into the action when the match can end. You know, boy, pinfall submissions. Look at this combination. My goodness. Chase Owens is, you know, completely fired up, completely focused. He could be about to pick up the win. Oh!
Taken down his own cover. Could it be?
God damn, he looks a bit under the rope. Doesn't matter. Chase Owens picks up the victory.
Chase Owens picking up the victory, a big victory over Drew Anderson as well.
An impressive victory for the Spartan. You know, back onto winning ways. You see how he, you know, continues on. If he can continue building on that, then get closer towards the future title shot.
For the title shot here. Now we're going to be moving on to tag team action as the boys will be going against, well, the newly addition to the clergy team. There's Justice Stone in there now.
Ah, poor Justice Stone. I can only imagine what they've done to him.
And as well, coming out first. They are the boys.
We'll find out momentarily, but right now, yeah, making their way to the ring on to Poise. He'll be looking to get a statement victory over the Clergy. Really show them up. You know, said it's always said, you know, about getting those wins at Club 5 rankings to get title shots. And that's what the boys want to do here tonight.
If you remember correctly from what Dom said, there is, of course, the tag with the Battlefront side of the tag network attention match. And well, if I were to deduct it, this would be it.
Well, it's a great opportunity, yeah, then for to poisoning. They've been impressive this season. We'll see if they can get into the Battlefront side of number contendership. So go against the Wolfpack.
Which one of these teams are going to be going against the Wolfpack next week to try and get a chance to go against the Prestige at Nowhere to Run?
Chavon Figueroa is here the 1 week from this Saturday? Or Sunday?
Saturday.
Ah.
Pay-per-views are Saturday now.
Yeah, I did remember that, you know, that discussion. I wasn't sure when exactly it was coming in.
Yeah, but now, coming out next, being led by our European champion, they are the Clergy.
We'll see if the Clergy could be the ones become number one contenders for the Battlefront side of the tag team titles. I won't lie, I'm kind of surprised when it comes to Justice Stone, his gear still hadn't changed to it.
Yes, he has free will. What do you not understand?
All the Clergy ran out of money, splashing out all that money on Brandon Alexander's weird mask.
You think the Clergy don't have money? He's the European champion. He's got money for days.
They're a five-man team. Oh, no. Oh, no, the boys have joined.
The music didn't stop for a moment. I was like, I got nervous.
Oh, no.
But it's
look for this. Oh, wow.
Well, we're going to get this match underway. Jason, not Jason, he wrestled already.
Jesus. I'm not a competitor.
Yeah, you like to critique.
I'm a journalist and it's my job.
So Jason, why are the Clergy won?
I'm not going for the Clergy. I believe Du Bois be the winners here tonight. You know, as I said, maybe, I don't know, maybe Justice Stone hasn't been changed. I don't see it yet. His gear's the same, but maybe his personality is different. Who knows?
Hey, I'm telling you, he has free will of himself, and he liked his original gear. He hasn't changed it yet. Maybe he might change it in the future, but for now, he likes his gear as is. And Jacob Wells is a man that likes to give free will. I don't know where you don't understand this. And now, now that he's under the Clergy, he's going to try and help him get out away from that losing record that he had before. He didn't even have a single win this season. But he was generous enough to give him a European title shot.
I mean, the way I was seeing how the Clergy were trying to get to him just so before, you know, interfere in his match to cost him from victory. I mean,
in the European Championship match?
What?
Where was it last week? Main event, European Championship match.
It wasn't then. It was before, though, that Jake Wells interfered during a matchup to cost Justice Stone, you know, another loss. So I don't fully trust the Clutches. Oh, no! See, look what the Clutches have done to him. They made Justice Stone do nasty things. Like throw Chesswad into our referee.
And now, what is Justice looking to do here? We're going to try and take him out here, but going to the outside.
And now Chesswad, look, what's he going for? Trying to lure him to the outside, and seems to have worked his own. Oh, goodness! What a German suplex. Jacob, keep your distance.
He's keeping his distance.
He looked like he was approaching. He was approaching them. I didn't like it. I didn't trust him.
What is there not to trust about our European champion?
Oh, a lot. See, look at this. He's distracting.
Hey, he's just giving him a good word in here. He's trying to talk to him. Maybe he's trying to get him to join. I don't know. He's just trying to distractions.
Unnecessary. He's doing it again.
Come on, Chase. Yes, you would love the Book of Wells.
He's trying to cost Chase Wild count out here.
He's just trying to promote his book. As we're up to an 8 count here.
You see, Chase Wild realized he needs to get back and he's done the right thing. He was going to go the way towards Jake Ross. You know Jake Ross would have distracted him again.
What?
Talking about his stupid book.
Well, Justice needs to get attacked here. He's trying to get one for Brandon. I think he got it. He tapped his leg, I think.
It still counts. He slapped him somewhere that caused, you know, crowd toss attack. But could be all for nothing.
Could it be? No. Only one count. Well, Georgie Mackin coming in here now. Let's see what he's going to do here. But no, throwing down the chop there from Georgie. Into the corner here.
Look, taking out the referee once again.
Listen.
But throwing Georgie Mackin to him.
He just got in the way.
No.
It's not my fault the ref, you know, didn't, you know, watch where he's going. He's best in the world!
Oh, God. He's definitely not.
But he hit it.
He hit it. That is for sure. That coast to coast.
And he hit the best in the world. They're not going for the cover. No, not even. Fine. Jeez.
You're clearly not best in the world. What do you think you're doing?
It's a huge hard corner there.
And he spiked George Rex's head into the mat, and George Nia needs to get attacked, and he does.
Yeah, we got Chase and Justice back inside the ring here, but oh, great move there by Chase. Chase Wild.
And Chase Wild, a step up Superman punch.
And now.
Oh! Up.
Huge shot kick. Is now going for the cover. One,
Alec.
Two, no. Now what it's just is looking to do is, look at that cut.
Yeah, he is bleeding badly. That is nasty. Side of his head as well. He's done the wrong thing over and getting a tag. See. Looks like he could need some stitches after this match.
Look at that big knee, Fred Alexander. Could he be thinking of it? Could it be the end? Cover. Two. No.
So Chase Wild was able to kick out, still fighting him.
George had some belief in him there. Now a big pull is right there by Chase Wild. Now I think he's going to get Georgie Mackin get the powerhouse.
And do the right thing. Get Georgie Mackin back into the ring here. And now, but no, Pranlon sort of catches him. And no, Georgie Mackin ducks under. And Justin had a fanny pack.
Yeah, just a fanny pack. You never know what might fall out of there.
Is there actually anything in there? It's just a fashion statement, and a very strange fashion statement.
What do you mean, strange fashion
statement? A bit strange to wear one of those during a match.
I think it's perfectly fine.
You would.
I mean, to be fair, I do think wearing it like on his back is a little bit weird. As though getting caught in the ropes there, didn't go for the cover. Yeah, I mean, it could cause some damage to the back if he did have something in there.
Hey, who knows? The referee should definitely check that before every match is in cover.
No.
George Mack's kick here now. Yeah, the referee should definitely, before we ring the bell for each of George Mack's matches to start, so you know, unzip that bag and check what's in there.
I don't think so. Justice, maybe starting to seem out of it after some blood loss.
Yeah, he is a woozy man. You can see that he's bleeding badly.
Well, instead of making a mistake for him, I try to get back into this match, try to get just a stone tagged back in. Man, do I have to do this by himself?
He may have to indeed. It's now the big knee. Now going for the cover. This is going to be it. One, two, three. And he does do it. The Clergy pick up the victory.
Oh, well, the Clergy pick up the win. See that blood on Chester Stone. He's going to need to get it cleaned up. He's going to need to get that stitched up. Well, it looks like the Clergy are going to be meeting the Wolfpack.
They're going to be in the Wolfpack. And guess what? That's a win for Chester Stone. Thanks to Jacob Wells.
Whatever.
But am I wrong?
Whatever.
Well, we're moving on to women's tag team action here. And coming out first, after a big win against Ruby Tower last week, they are Short Girl Rock.
And they're coming out together this week, and no swords.
No swords. Coming out together, matching its powers here. We're matching power schemes. Now,
supposed to match it. I was being matching color schemes. Well, you see, think about it. If Short Girls Rock can win here tonight, that has to put them up there as number one contenders to the women's tag team titles. As they haven't struck, they were struggling to decide who was going to walk up the steps first.
I mean, they found out. It was going to be Violet.
They're like, no, you. All right, I'll go.
Nice with each other.
I mean,
what's wrong with that?
I think Zora and I can make for a great tag team and then get along well. That's what tag teams are about, is you don't get along, that coexisting, and Short Girls Rock certainly seem to understand that.
As well, coming out next, they are our women's tag team champion, the Sisters.
Well, the Sisters are also a team that understands that of getting along and being a cohesive unit. And it's why they are the women's tag team champions. And they're going to look to try and put Short Girls Rock down a few steps on that ladder to make sure it's not Short Girls Rock getting a future title shot against them.
Non-title action here tonight. Let's see how Short Girls Rock do against the tag team champions. Of course, on the left, Rebecca looking, Eve Sparks on the right here. They are looking ready here tonight to try and, well, try and continue their tag team dominance.
That's what we're looking to do, best. It's going to be easy, but this match is going to be a hard fought one between two great teams.
As well, Jason, who you got going in this one?
No, might actually go for Short Girls Rock. I think they've got a great opportunity here tonight to show they deserve a shot at the women's tag team titles as a cover. No, an easy kick out. If they can defeat the women's tag team champions here tonight, Short Girls Rock will definitely show they deserve that title opportunity.
Well, you gotta think about it like this, though. If we weren't anything from last week, what goes on in MVE, they don't want to, get whipped, as to speak, as we hear is what happens. Now, I was able to find out that if Eve or Rebecca lose in a singles match, they don't get whipped because that's not their specialty. It's in tag matches that they would get punished.
Still, a little strange. They get whipped together. I thought the Clergy was strange in what they do, but MVE might actually be worse.
It could very well be. The Mercer versus Everfin, of course, the Sisters are part of that, of course. Also, in that stable, of course, is Jay Mercer and Alex Klein. Both of them looking to try and get wins in their own rights there. Alex has been looking to try, of course, get the Women's Championship somewhere down the line. Jay Mercer next Saturday looking to try and get a win, become the first ever two-time Triple Crown champion. We could also very well see Roger Riley be the first ever person to retain the championship, but he did not make it easy on himself.
No, he sunk his whole big spear. Could that be the one thing that could be, you know, oddly his saving grace? Is the fact he's, you know, there's five other people in the match, but it's elimination style. So, you know, he has to get pins to be eliminated. Given the fact of, you know, he's the last person in there, the number six entry. Time he gets in there, his other opponents are, you know, going to be worn out. The only person that may be on his level but is still taking damage is the number five entry, which is Jay Mercer. It oddly could work in his favor. Oh, that's only going to work in your favor. It's a nasty brainbuster.
Yeah, very nasty brainbuster. Eastberg's looking to follow Violet here onto the outside. Violet was trying to catch her in a kick, wasn't able to get it. Attacking that arm of Sparks here.
Now, oh goodness, and then a patch up. I'm not sure if Sparks the back of her head hit the two steps in the way down, but it sure looked like it. Now look at the leaping abilities.
Yeah, the giant leaping abilities is now Fire continuing here on Sparks. Oh, now further middle of the ring, the middle of the outside here.
It's up to a six count. Now Sparks says she's going to go back out.
Going back out. Resetting the count. And I did get a little bit of an update so far on, you know, the styles of what's going on here with MVE. It's actually Alex that does the work, apparently.
Oh.
Not Jay. Jay doesn't get involved.
Okay. So when she loses, who whips her?
I'm currently...
Is it one of those things she does it to herself?
It might be.
There are people that do that.
There are. There's a lot. Crucifix here on the outside, as we're going to be up to an 8 count in just a moment here. And they need to get back inside the ring. Bob Edwards gets back inside. But she does not want to win by count out, as it seems like almost nobody wants to win by count out this year.
Yeah, no one really does. I mean, I'd expect, you know, some count out victories by the slightly more, you know, devious stars on our roster that don't really care about how they get victories. Jay Mercer being one of them. But everyone seems to want to win legitimately this season.
Alright. So, we're getting another update to this story.
Okay.
If Alex moves, I don't think she has yet this season. Wait, quick over here. No, what? Apparently, Jay would step in, but he doesn't think it would affect her.
And they claim this whole thing isn't kink-based.
Well, no, it's punishment.
Sounds like bullshit!
But anyway...
No, Jay's saying he'll only get involved if Alex loses. Yeah. So what he's basically saying is he likes to watch Alex Klein whip other people.
Apparently so.
That cuck weirdo. Oh god, what a kick.
So what, you think he's got like a white tank top on and like got a camera? Just watching?
Yes, probably.
Wow.
This week's Ring the Bell Wrestling homework.
Now,
find Jay's weird videos.
Now, when I put this video, when this video goes up on YouTube, when they ask, is this made for children? We say no.
That's a straight up fuck no. Because I already dropped the F-bomb earlier in the show.
Yeah. As we do every show.
I mean, you know what one of my favorite activities is?
Go on.
Flipping off children, especially during autograph sessions.
Are you who's gonna sign?
Maybe. Some fans try to get a picture of me, and I spend my time on the phone instead.
That sounds about right.
You know, more important things.
Well, what more important things do you have, Jason? Like sewing a coat with William Jackson's blood on it again?
Yeah, I've got merchandise to sell and booty calls to get. There's, oh goodness, a big takedown.
Wait a minute. Violet's saying she wants Casey to do it.
Yeah, she's like, finish her.
But that allowed Eastmark to get back.
Oh, and she gets scored to the Hurricane Runner for her troubles.
Violet, maybe you should have
Violet, you may want to, you know, step in. Casey Blade's in trouble. Now you want to attack.
One count.
Just a one count. I don't know what's going on between Shulk and Hazard, what that was all about. Maybe they've got a weird tactic that makes at least sense to them.
Maybe she thought Eve was weak at that moment and that she needed to capitalize, but Casey took too long, and then of course Eve was able to fight back. But now look at this, Casey able to take down Eve and into a huge kick there.
I suppose to believe that's the case, it's a miscommunication from Short Cow's Rock, and then it's not suffered a tag team like them once. Okay, and there we go.
Now we can get fired over back in. Now she's going to see her opportunity here. What you looking to go for? Going outside.
What's she going for? Oh no, this looks bad. This looks really bad. Oh my god.
Jeez. But Eve didn't even care.
No, she was like, nah, nothing.
Big fireman's here, five hours from now. What is she looking to do? Big kick there, taking down Eve. And now we're going to get Casey Blade back inside. Great quick tags here, but oh, Eve's up. And it's boot goes Casey Blade.
Yeah, she looked like she was just playing some possum there. She was just lying in wait. It's helped her eyes look at these big kicks.
Oh, we're in front of Violet Edwards here.
And just continue on it now.
And the knockout blow. Could that be enough?
Yeah, could it be? And Kesper could legitimately be knocked out as a
hook
cover.
Of the leg, up just the leg. Like you like it? No, no answer. No, oh my god, super kick there by Rebecca Wicked.
It looks like Violet Edwards was willing to get the hell out of there, and Rebecca Wicked was having none of it.
And now, drop toll here, Casey Blade, able to continue on Eastmark Sears, into the knee.
Brutally inside the knee, now cover, hook in the leg. But look who's right there. I think, you know, if it weren't for Rebecca Wicked, I think that could have been it. It could have been over.
Not able to
get the tag. It's an trying for a boot there. No kick into the guts.
Look at the scissor hold here.
The scissor hold going, but oh, look at these nasty elbows. Moves boxes out of it. And oh, big swim by it, and then a drop kick.
Rebecca Wicked getting tagged in. Casey looks like she's trying to get the Violet.
Yeah, she's trying to reach.
She does.
Yes, she gets there in the last split second. And here comes Violet Edwards with a big crossbody.
Yeah, big jumping crossbody here. Now she's looking to go up high. She's all set up.
Yeah, she's turning
look
around.
At this.
The hang time on the moonsaults.
She knows that Casey Blade not in the corner, and she went for the cover easier. She's gonna break it up, but she hesitated, and that allowed Rebecca Wicked to get some air and get caught up. And oh, now is she looking to do big boot?
Big pimping home.
Breaker Wicked is able to counter him. Just a one count. I don't think Casey Play would have got there in time had it got to a three count. Survivor's caught the leg. Trips it down and now. Looks like she wants to tag to Casey Play, but Casey Play looks, you know, exhausted.
Casey Play still looking out of there. They're trying to continue those quick tags, but I think now Casey's getting a little exhausted here. But now look at this, Violet has her. Oh, I thought she had her, but into a stunner there. And now, what is Rebecca looking to do? Cover two.
No. Yeah. Just go for an easy kill then. It's not hooking her leg, but at the same time, it looks like Fred, sorry, Casper could have got there. This match continues on. Look at this. Oh, goodness, raking at the face.
Nothing about it there. And now, Rebecca picking up. Five others again. Went for a kick. Was he able to hit? Now, into the corner. No, not able to get the tag. Oh, now Casey's tagging herself in. I don't think Rebecca would get so up. But no, maybe she did play a possum there.
She did, but oh, big headbutt. And then an STO takedown.
Big attack of the arm. And now what is Casey looking to do? Now taking it down. Face first into turnbuckle, gets the tag.
Gets the tag. For some double team kick. Offense.
Oh, sister steps on now. Why would Evans, what's she looking to do?
Oh no. Rebecca Wicked able to counter, but no. Devon Edwards counters and brings her down and spins around her.
Stepping on the hands.
He's stepping on the hand and then stomping the arm. It's done some serious damage, but you can see Rebecca Wicked once again finding a counter.
Hands are up.
But no! Firewoods. Goodness! A beautiful Paracarana. And now she be dancing.
Dancing? She got them dancing feet. And oh, kissing over to E Sports, maybe trying to kiss this to deny. As oh, big fall there. Byron Edwards, no.
Sizing her up. Super kick.
Super kick right in front of E Sports, though. Cover. One.
These boxes again
two,
in the ring.
Three. Short comes rock. Pick up the picture and fight. Expected Rebecca to kick out there, but she didn't. Big win for Violet Edwards and Casey Blade.
Yeah, big time victory for them. Short Cows will get the victory. You gotta think, it's gotta put them up there. Future number one contenders for women's tag team titles.
Dom from the past saying, well, after that swerve of victory, I'm not mad at our tag team champions, but I am disappointed. So they will have a chance to redeem themselves next Saturday at Nowhere to Run, as the sisters will be defending their tag titles against Short Girls Rock.
Oh my goodness, well, that is a huge announcement from Dom, and the right one. Short Girls Rock get a chance to become tag team champions, and well, the sisters a chance at redemption.
Dom, our new GM, already making big moves here. Well, we're going to be moving on to our main event of the evening. Huge triple threat match. Three members of Battlefront in the chamber are going to be going against each other here. Let's see who's going to get some big momentum going into next Saturday.
So yeah, that's what the match will definitely be all about, is the big time momentum. Who can get that big boost? Could it be this individual?
Yeah, it's coming out first. It is Jay Mercer.
A man who later on tonight could be getting whipped like the weirdo he is.
Could very well be. I mean, already the sisters are looking to be going towards that way right now.
Yeah, they certainly are. No, if I was the sisters, I'd want to get a hell away, you know, as far away from this creep as I could. Yes, you can join my group, but if you lose, get whipped. Ugh.
Well, by Alex Klein, of all people, as well. Not Jay. Jay doesn't do it. He doesn't like it, I guess.
Well, he just watches it get done, but whatever. We'll see if it could be Jay Mercer who could get momentum here tonight, going towards, of course, or his chance to try to become only two-time Triple Crown champion.
And of course, Jay's going to be looking to try and pick up that opportunity here. We'll see if he will be able to do that next Saturday in the Elimination Chamber. But for now, he's going to be looking to try and get some big momentum here. As well, coming out next, another man, former Triple Crown champion, Travis Turner.
And Travis Turner will be looking to get a big time momentum too. Of course, said, yeah, also a former Triple Crown champion, so would love to become the only two-time. And the victory here tonight gets him momentum. It's, you know, momentum is very important, very key. You know, building your confidence towards, you know, important matches. So Travis Turner will be looking to get.
Of course, he was able to beat Sandy of Sin, and then he lost it to Vaishon. We know what happened from there. But Travis Turner, I mean, so far no one has been able to defend that Triple Crown Championship. I honestly don't even think. I don't even think Elijah Riley is going to defend it. He's putting himself even higher on the level. He's putting himself in the Elimination Chamber, and right now two former Triple Crown champions are in that chamber.
Yeah, he's really in a way shot himself in the foot with that one. But who knows, it could be, you know, the greatest tactic ever. I mean, it looks mental in one way, but who knows, he could take advantage of the fact he's the last man in there and, you know, prey on a bunch of wounded competitors.
Coming out next, he is the father of fear, Amir Bates.
Third year to Amir Bates to the mix. He actually, you know, he got into the Elimination Chamber match and Nowhere to Run by defeating Elijah Riley. So he's got big momentum already. We'll see if he can get more momentum here tonight.
Continue on his role here. Like you said, he got a big win over Rajarelli to get into the chamber. He was able to pick up that challenge by Rajarelli. He had a big singles challenge, non-title. And then we saw Amir Bates pick up that win, make his way into the chamber. I mean, in this match, just from the Battlefront side alone, we have the first ever Triple Crown champion in Jay Mercer. Former Triple Crown champion in Travis Turner. A man that's pinned the current Triple Crown champion. This is not going to be an easy match.
No, it certainly isn't. It's not going to be easy for any of the six individuals. It's going to be a brutal matchup where it's all based on not only do the numbers matter, but it's also, you know, the punishment you can take that matters, which you can also dish out.
Jackson and Xavier Walker as well, and of course our Triple Crown champion Elijah Riley. Those are going to be the six men inside that chamber. I mean, as far as, you know, the top star talents going into this, I almost want to say Apex is kind of like on the downward side, the people that are like the dark horses going in, because these three men right here, each of them Well, two of them are former Triple Crown champions. One, if the title was on the line, could have been Triple Crown champion. I mean, this is great talent coming out of Battlefront going into that chamber.
It's, yes, but that's, sure if it's so that way, Pest could maybe take Rogers. Yeah, he said Dark Horse is in it, and it could surprise people, but in a sense, when it comes to Battlefront sides, you've got, yeah, three people on quite a bit of mental, so, former champion's a man who's defeated the current champion. So look at that from Jay Mercer.
Yeah, Jay just working over on Travis Stern here, and now Amir Bates. We're just working over on Jay, but he's not allowing Jay to recover here. Went for a kick.
Certainly not.
And look, just went back inside the ring.
Immediately back in to focus onto Travis Turner's. Oh, look at those kicks. But look, Jay Mercer, look at that.
Oh, into a DDT. Now Amir rolling to the outside. That leaves Jay alone with Travis Turner here. The two former Triple Crown champions meeting here.
It's half and half suplex. Travis Turner is feeling fired up right now.
Yeah, now what is Travis looking to do? But no, he's going to allow Jay back in and well punch him as he gets in, but now getting caught by the Father of Fear. And oh, Jay catching the Father of Fear when he was had his guard down. But no, Father of Fear able to fight back here.
It has him. Oh! Black hole slam from Amir Bates. Jay Mercer runs the outside. You see Travis Turner launches Amir Bates to the outside.
And all three men on the outside now. Jay trying to catch a breath. Amir fighting Travis Turner. Travis fighting back now. Oh, look at this!
Oh my god!
Pile driver on the outside!
And spinning tombstone Pacha on. That padded floor shows it just doesn't really offer protection. Oh goodness!
My goodness. The brutality of Travis Turner here. Now it's just gonna be Jay and Travis inside. Honestly, it's feel bad for Amir Bates though, but that is what Travis Turner needs to do. He needs to bring that sort of brutality, especially when he's gonna go against five of her men. That would be hungry for that Triple Crown Championship.
Yeah, definitely. This has to be about the Triple Crown Championship. So all six men here can just put their all into that matchup to really prove what they've got to see who walks out as Triple Crown Champion. Oh no.
Oh, now we're gonna get a bat in here as well. The Father Bear bringing the baseball bat to Jay Mercer.
I mean, Jay's no stranger to getting hit with weapons, but I don't think he's really a fan of being hit by a bat.
And now throwing Jay throwing Amir Bates back inside the ring. Travis Turner looking to meet Amir Bates inside. Now Jay maybe thinking of grabbing a chair here, or he's. Or maybe not.
He's just gonna walk into the barricade.
Do you think he's walking? He's trying to run away from the fear of Amir Bates.
Maybe. Or maybe he's trying to figure out how to levitate.
Yeah, I mean, Chase.
It's Chase Wild thing. It's his power. It's weird. Sorry, Chase Owens.
You were thinking of the boys.
Yeah. My bad.
Yeah, but now Amir Bates, we use that chair against Jay. Cutter! Oh, now look at this! That's our Dragon Sweeper.
Inside Dragon Sweeper. I mean, Jay's foot there.
Yeah, but the stream rules, it doesn't matter.
Yeah, that's true. In any other case, that would be rope break, but you know, the extreme rules setting means that rope breaks aren't a thing. It's both those two taunting, and oh! Speed of Jay Mercer. Cover, no hook in the leg, and Travis Turner kicks out.
Well, I mean, he didn't hook the leg.
Yeah, exactly. The fool.
I imagine
he should get whipped just for that alone. Even if he wins,
I think he's going to win.
No, no, I said even if he wins, he should still get whipped each time he didn't hook the leg or the pin. Alex Scott, if you're listening, you know I make sense.
Yeah, but now Travis Turner, what is he looking at do? Flatliner!
A sure fun on us. You can see him here, it has the chair, but couldn't use it. Travis Turner was much too quick.
And now, what is Travis looking to do? Has him up!
Has him up, and oh! DDT brings and he picks down the hard way. And now, oh, goodness, into the steel steps.
Oh, and now Amir grabbing that chair, going back inside the ring. Was he going back outside the ring? Should he going after Travis Turner here? But all three men right here. Oh, what's Jay looking to do? Nope. Amir able to stop him. But, oh! And hitting Travis Turner there. It looked like it was intended, though, for Jay Mercer.
Yeah, it looked like it. It's just a complete mess on the outside. He's from in that corner. He's going to get very dangerous, but Amir Bates thrown away from there. It's now Jay Mercer. What has he got planned?
Now, oh, now Jay has Amir Bates up.
Ramos going on a knee and now has him up. And now Amir Bates is able to throw Jay in the ring. Oh no. Oh, could it's brutalizing Jay Mercer once again with that baseball bat.
Yes, now Amir Bates going for the cover. 2-3!
And, oh, and Amir Bates the Fuji after using the baseball bat as a weapon. We'll say. Dom will neither be mad nor disappointed with that. He loves baseball.
He loves baseball indeed. Baseball bat for the victory. Amir Bates, the father of fear, picking up the big victory, picking up huge momentum towards the Elimination Chamber. Well, he just pinned a former Triple Crown champion. He pinned a current Triple Crown champion. Momentum through the roof for Amir Bates.
Oh yeah, definitely huge momentum for Amir Bates. Could we be looking at the future Triple Crown champion?
It could very well be indeed. Well guys, that is it. Jason, say goodbye to the fans.
Goodbye, fans.
And well guys, I'm of course your main commentator, John Ottman. Drive fast, take chances. I will see you guys all this Monday night for Apex. See you there.